Welcome to This Is My Architecture. I am Gerardo, and I'm joined today by Gerald from American Family Group. Welcome, Gerald.
Thank you for having me, sir.
So, Gerald, what is American Family Group?
American Family Group is a parent company of several insurance companies, one of which is Main Street America. I work for American Family Group, and the architecture that we're talking about is for Main Street America. It's for independent agents.
Okay, great. So I hear that you are in the middle of a migration and transformation of a legacy application, and it's happening as we speak.
Yes, we're modernizing this application as we speak.
That's good. Can you run me through some of the components and what you've modernized so far?
Sure. As I go through, I'll talk about which ones. Well, the agents come in and they request the single page application. Mm-hmm. We've modernized that. It used to be on an Apache. Now it's served up from an S3 bucket through a cloud front to the application.
Great.
Then, when they're making calls to the back end, they come into, it used to be on some load balanced on-prem Tomcat servers running Java script. Now they come into an API gateway. The first thing that API gateway is use a modern Lambda authorizer to validate that they do have access. It makes the calls to this Lambda here, which is a serverless Python Lambda, so it can scale up and down easily. That particular Lambda then decides, we've modernized by moving in some of the functions into the Lambda, into the Lambdas in the serverless stack, but we still haven't moved the whole application. So for some things, it calls up to here, who calls back down there.
Okay, so some of the functionality is still sitting in the Tomcat application.
Yes, it is, sir.
Can you give me some examples of the functionality that's still there and what's been moved to the serverless world?
Well, some things like our user management are still there because we haven't had to move it yet. When we're moving stuff is when either there's a new feature change, okay, so anything new is being implemented in the serverless stack. Okay. If there's enhancements, significant enhancements to a function, they're also being then migrated and moved into a more modern serverless Python stack. Mm-hmm. And lastly, of course, the dreaded bugs. If this is a significant bug, not a one-liner or a two-liner, but something significant, that piece of code is modernized. So we're slowly strangling this Tomcat.
Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. So out of these components, we still need to talk about this.
Oh,
so what's this Dynamo DB type?
Well, the Dynamo DB is used for storing caching the user information. So when a user comes in, we cache it. And we do it in DynamoDB for a couple reasons. One, the Lambda, you can hit another instance of the Lambda next time you make an API call. Mm-hmm. So we can't cache it on the machine there. This DynamoDB is a regional one, so everything in the region. So as one of these Lambdas is running in availability zone A and others in B, they can both access that cache of information. Mm-hmm. Then lastly, of course, if, I know it doesn't ever happen, but if availability zone A would go down, then you know the ones running in B can access it without a pause.
Yeah, that makes sense. That makes sense. So have you started realizing some of the benefits of the modernization that you're going through?
Actually, we have. Yeah. First off, we've been able to shut down 25 on-prem servers. We've also seen our user satisfaction increase by 25% of what it used to be. And because of that user satisfaction, the agents are excited about this, and they will talk to their fellow agents saying, you know, you got to go give that application a new chance. So we've actually seen 10% new users coming in, which is selling more policies for us. And lastly, of course, using the Lambdas and all are much cheaper than running a bunch of on-prem servers.
Thank you so much for sharing this great modernization story with us.
Thank you for having me and allowing me to present it.
And thank you for watching This Is My Architecture. See you next time.